Place in my life, and Leaguer wanted to have a lot of fun on this record, but I also wanted to experiment with sounds that I haven't used before, like on the production. Like my song Hello Kitty has kind of like an electronic feel to it, but then I've got my classic ballads, and I have a duet with Chad, and then like a bunch of pop tunes with like a rock edge. So it's actually quite diverse, the album. You're the only one that I want with me. You know how the story goes. When it's you. So I wrote this song, Bad Girl, and I was listening to it, and it just made me think of Manson. So I was like, he would be amazing on this track. So I just texted him, I called him up, and he came over to the studio, and he listened to it, and he liked the track, and then he laid down some vocals. He just came up with, like, on the spot, and it sounds really cool, and I was really honored to be able to work with him, because I respect him as an artist and his music and his like his style, and he's a really smart person. So I love the track Bad Girl. I ain't never gonna cover up that tattoo. I might have a couple of shows. You say me too. Like, people are so busy. Well, like, it's actually not that easy. I don't know, like, I've never really done too much of the collaborating thing before, and just with songwriting, really. So, like, having Chad on the record was, like, a natural step because he was writing with me. Collaborations, you know, you kind of, like, think about people you know, you reach out and you hope that they like your music, if you like their music, so. Love that one song on the wall. Used to mean something, but now it means nothing. Well, our relationship was just, it was really easy. It was like writing songs for me. And like, he has his opinion, and I respect his opinion because he's an amazing songwriter and he's had so much success. So, like, we both respect each other and each other's opinions, and I have like a different style than he does. So, like, when I'm doing my crazy thing in the studio and going to my girly land, all my ideas that he would never have thought of, like, that are like kind of like younger or whatever and this and that, like, he'll look at me and be like, huh, I never would have thought of that, but I like that, yeah, let's try that idea. And with him, like, he's a really good lyricist, so he comes up with things that I wouldn't have thought of, like, lyrically, and I'm like, oh. So it's a good mix, because we both have totally different styles. Gotta follow whatever, but it's getting my strong singing. Here's to never growing up. I try to write anthems, so I like that. And it's a song for everybody. It doesn't matter what age you are. It's really about the spirit of youth and you know, being young at heart, wanting to be young forever, and it doesn't really matter what age you are. We don't ever stop, and we're never gonna change. Yeah, I think you're right, and I'm really curious to see, like, the reaction from the song and, like, how it is live, but so far, like, the fans, they seem to really be embracing it, and that's sort of a way of life, you know, being a free spirit, living in the moment, making the best of every situation. I think that it's good to always try to connect with your fans, and that's what I do. Like, I spend so much of my time touring, so I put in the work of, like, going to visit and going on tour to all the different countries and all the different cities across the entire world. And it takes years to do that, and like, one whole tour for me will take like 1 year. Mm-hmm. I usually do promo before it, so like, my first three albums, I spent 2 years on the road for each album. And it's important to, like, for me now, I get to use Twitter and connect with the fans and see what they're saying and ask them questions if I want, and meet and greets and signing after the shows. Really just giving it all that you can. If you stay forever, hey, we can stay forever young. It's important, and it's nice. I like to meet my fans and to see them in person, and that's really the reason why I love putting on concerts, like going out on stage and, like, like actually seeing them there and singing along. And then it's nice meeting them afterwards because I'm always curious, like to see, like I know they want to see me and get autographs, but they also say things to me, like they talk about the songs and what they like and how much the song meant to them, and that, like ultimately, that makes me feel good because I put so much into my songs, my music, and the whole writing process. Say, won't you say forever stay? If you stay forever, hey, we can stay forever.